Hi, we're Krish, Pranav, and Jensen, and we're going to talk about Wisconsin versus Yoder. So what exactly happened? Three Amish families, the Yoders, Millers, and Utes, were fined $5 for pulling their children out of Wisconsin's education system, due to its mandates requiring all kids aged 16 or under to attend school. Amish families normally choose to pull their kids out of school right after 8th grade, giving their children ample time to undergo their traditional vocational training. This ended up being a massive problem for their religion.
The Amish families argued that the law violated the First Amendment's Free Exercise Clause, which prohibited the federal government and state governments after the 14th Amendment from encroaching on citizens' right to practice their religion, but preventing their people from practicing their religion's tradition of vocational training. Wisconsin School District argued that the limit allows high school students to choose their path that they want to take their own choice. According to them, the 16-year-old requirement ensured that neither the parents nor the school had too much influence over the student's choice. The Berger Supreme Court unanimously decided that Wisconsin's fine towards Amish families was unconstitutional due to the First Amendment's Free Exercise Clause, which stated that their religious practices cannot be overstepped by Wisconsin's state interest.
Modern Amish dissenters now look to overturn or at least modify the decision, since Amish education may no longer be enough for many of their children. The traditional Amish vocational training has fallen behind due to the increase in importance of higher level education for most jobs since the decision was originally made in 1972. Why should we care about this case? Along with Engel v. Vital, which utilized the Establishment Clause of the First Amendment, Wisconsin v. Yoder set the largely unchallenged precedent that an individual's right to exercise their religious beliefs under the First Amendment takes priority over the state's interests in compulsory education, as long as this behavior does not incite violence or heavy disturbance to other people. This precedent also later led to the modern-day possibility of homeschooling. In short, Wisconsin v. Yoder used the First Amendment's Free Exercise Clause in conjunction with the 14th Amendment to ensure that states don't encroach on citizens' right to religion.
Thank you.